Hello, and welcome to Studio Sessions, our weekly video where we share crafts and kits from our second floor makerspace, the studio. My name is Amber, and I am the studio associate. Today, I am going to be teaching you how to make window-mounted hummingbird feeders. These are really cute and quick projects that can help attract hummingbirds to your yard. So you need just a few supplies for this one. You need approximately 2 feet of wire. In this instance, we're using this 18-gauge copper wire. This is easy enough that you can manipulate it by hand and you don't need special wire cutters or anything. If you wanted to make a heavier dutier one, you certainly could go with some thicker wire, but this is what we'll be using today. You need a couple of silk red flowers. I got mine from this large bunch that I found at the dollar store, and I just cut them off so that I've got a little bit of a green stem left. I have some red pony beads as well, and then a suction cup that has enough of an area on that you can wrap the wire around it. And then we'll be using these little flower vials that are often used for boutonnieres and things like that to be the actual piece that holds the hummingbird nectar. And it's also optional, depending on what you're going to do with the flowers, you might want a hot glue gun. I have one with me today. We'll see where our project takes us because we've got a few different kinds of options. So as you can see from these are all made slightly differently. I have some that I've started the wire on the suction cup and then just twirled it all the way down. I have some that I worked from the middle and then went out two different ways. So we are going to do something similar to this one here today. So what I did there is I took roughly the midpoint of my wire and put it around the suction cup a few times. And then I kind of gave myself a little bit of space. I don't want it straight up next to the window because I don't want the hummingbirds to run into the window while they're trying to get to the hummingbird feeder. So you need to give them some space. Also, I like the idea of having it tilted a little bit so that the hummingbird can still get the nectar out and it won't be sitting straight up and having some at the bottom. So from there, I'm going to do this one a little bit differently. I'm going to string on a couple of my beads here. We also want to make sure that we have red, not just to attract the hummingbirds, but also so they can tell the difference between the feeder and your window. So once you've got it about far enough away that you're happy with it, you can start twisting it around underneath the lid there a few times until you feel like it's secure. And then you can take the other end and you can take this to make a perch. Now on a couple of these, I put a little bead on the end. I'm not gonna do that on this one, but you could. So I'm just gonna make a little spiral there that the hummingbird could sit on if it was so inclined. And then I'm going to take the other half of my wire and twist it around to kind of catch the beads so that they don't slide totally freely. And this also strengthens it a little bit to hold it out. So now you've kind of got it like that. And then I'm going to take the rest of it down. I'm going to put another bead on here. And then just make a little spiral at the end to kind of hold that bottom part in so that it will stick out like that. So to get the hummingbird to the top, what we're going to do is take this flower off of the green stem. Maybe. And it has a little hole in it from where it was on the stem. So I'm going to make sure that the hole lines up with the big hole in this. And I don't want to glue there because that is where the hummingbird's going to drink out of it. So I'm just going to put a couple little dabs around the very edge so that it doesn't interfere with that middle part. And then center the flower on there. And that gives the hummingbird something to aim for. So this is a really easy and cute little project. And making the hummingbird food to put in it is also very easy. It's just 4 parts water to 1 part sugar. And you can keep that in your refrigerator. And I really like doing it on the smaller scale because I do have larger hummingbird feeders at my house, which you are supposed to clean every other day or at least twice a week. And it's easy to forget when you put loads in there and you look outside and you think, oh, there's still loads in there. It'll be fine for a little while. But it can grow mold quite quickly. When you're working on a smaller scale, you're kind of forced to clean it and refresh it more frequently. So that can actually end up being a little bit healthier for the hummingbird. So you can make a big batch, keep it in your fridge for a couple of weeks, and then just slide this out of the wire, give it a good wash, put your new food in there, and put it back out on the window. So this is a fun little project. You really could get super creative with it. If you had multiples, you could do a much longer piece of wire. I've seen some where people have looped 3 different ones together, going out at different directions and things like that. So you could make it bigger, more of a statement piece. Every one I make comes out slightly differently. I think of a different way I want to try it. So this can really give you some lots of fun options, and you could have one for lots of different windows in your house. Especially if you're working from home or something, it might give you a little friend who comes to visit. So I hope you try out our window-mounted hummingbird feeder and stay crafty.